All right, once again, we are going to get into Android TV and Raspberry Pi. I have posted a video on this before, but there is now an update that can make your experience faster and better. As I have shown you before, this is all made possible thanks to constakang.com, and that is where we are going to be heading to download what we need to get started. Using your PC, Mac or Linux, insert a microSD card in the proper slot in your computer or in the microSD card reader. Open up constakang.com, go to Devices, Raspberry Pi 4, and click on this link. This is the most recent version as of the time of making this video. Just keep in mind that this will change in the future. Click and download. Once that's downloaded, we need to go back to the home page and download Opengapps. This will allow us to install Google Play Store. Before proceeding, we need to grab a USB flash drive and copy Opengapps file to it. Wait for it to copy. Remove the USB flash drive and set it aside. We will need it later on. The next thing we are going to need to do is to write the operating system, Android TV in our case, to the microSD card. We do this using Raspberry Pi Imager. Raspberry Pi Imager is available on raspberrypi.org and it's free to download and to use. Once we get Raspberry Pi Imager started, we need to choose OS, Custom, and find Lineage OS Android TV that we downloaded earlier. We're going to select it, choose SD card while ensuring that we have the correct drive, and click Write. Once that's complete, we need to remove the SD card from the computer and slide it in the microSD card slot in the Raspberry Pi and start it. This can take a while, so be patient. The rest of this part is all easy stuff. Simply follow the instructions on the screen. You do not need to set up a pin. You can always do it later. I prefer to do that at the end when I have everything downloaded. Next thing we need to do is grab the flash drive where we saved Opengapps. We need to insert that in any available USB port on the Pi. After that, we need to go to Settings, Device Preferences, About, click 5 times on Build, right click to go back to the previous menu, click on Developer Options, enable Advanced Reboot, right click to go back, click on About, Restart, and select Recovery to boot to recovery. The system should boot into recovery mode. Go ahead and swipe to allow modification, install, select storage. If you do not see the flash drive, as it is the case for me here, remove the flash drive and reinsert it back in the USB port. Next, select the USB drive and click OK. Select Opengapps, swipe the confirm flash, and wait for that to complete. Click Wipe Dalvik, swipe to wipe, and reboot the system. When the system reboots, you will see this remote control. It's okay if you don't have it. I, however, recommend buying one of these remote controls if you plan on using the system on a regular basis. To get out of this screen, hit Enter and follow the instructions on the screen. Here, you have the option to use your phone or the remote. Choosing Use Remote will allow you to use the keyboard and mouse as well. Now hit Enter on your keyboard to move through this part, and that should be all. You can now start adding your favorite apps. Android TV on Raspberry Pi remains the best option for entertainment in my opinion. This is my daily driver, and I actually have one dedicated to a projector, and as I mentioned earlier, a remote control is a must-have if you are considering using a Raspberry Pi with Android TV. Now, I know some of you guys had problems with Netflix, Wi-Fi, and Bluetooth in the previous version. I can confidently say that Bluetooth and Wi-Fi are super reliable with this version. Netflix is still not available for this build, and you will not be able to see it in the App Store. Okay, this brings us to the end of this video. I hope this was helpful. If this is something you liked, don't forget to like and subscribe. As always, thank you for watching. Catch you next time.